started off, I got introduced to music at a very, very young age.
Yeah.
What it is, when I was really, really young, very young, my grandmother used to play an instrument called a dolok. A dolok is, it's a bit like the big drum I play, the dol,
yeah,
the one with the sticks, but it's smaller and it's played with the hands.
Yeah.
What it is, my grandmother used to play this at the temple every Saturday with the women's congregation. You know, they would, every Saturday afternoon they would get together and sing hymns.
Mm.
You know, and my grandmother would accompany them by playing the dolok.
Mm.
And being so young at that time, I used to sit in her lap. And I used to get forced to sit in her lap. And I used to listen to her play and then watch how she, you know,
yeah,
watch her technique.
Work.
Yeah. And it's from there that I picked it up.
Mm.
I picked up, you know, basic rhythm from there and finger work and hand technique.
Mm. Timing.
Timing especially.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then what happened then was, I got into it and my grandmother had a dolok at home. So, you know, whenever I'd see it, I used to play it. And then what happened was, my my grandma actually, she saw me once, you know, playing, and she thought, wow, you know,
you got some skills.
There's something there. Yeah, yeah. And then she actually brought me my first dolok.
Yeah.
And then I started playing. The more I played, the more I practiced,
the better
I got,
yeah,
so to speak. And then I played dolok, and then I went into dobla. I heard dobla, and I thought, wow, that sounds great. You got a high, you got a low.
Yeah.
It's very sort of. All this intricate sort of
detail. Yeah, yeah. Movements.
Wow. Yeah. So then I started learning dobla. I learned dobla, which is the two drums,
yeah,
for 11 years. And then I got scared because I was getting into classical dobla.
Yeah.
And then what happened was that
you got trapped a bit in
there. Yeah, I got scared because I didn't want to be held down.
Yeah.
Because once you go into classical dobla, you got to stay there.
Yeah, you got to.
You know, you got to give it everything you've got.
That's what classical means.
Exactly.
The beginning. Just
exactly. And then I thought, oh my God, there are big musicians in the classical world. And I sort of got scared. I thought, oh, I can't do this.
Yeah.
But you know, I thought, you know, if I do go into it, I have to give it everything. I have to focus just on classical.
Mm.
And that, I mean, I felt that didn't give me this sort of freedom to play other instruments, to play other sort of grooves, other beats, you know, things like that.
And it would bring a certain kind of critique, wouldn't it?
Exactly.
Which is not really useful.
I mean, if you're into the classical, you know, the classical way of life, then obviously, you know, it's useful to you.
Mm.
But if you're not really into that sort of thing, then, you know, it's far out.
Mm.
You see what I mean?
Yeah, sure.
But then also, what happened at the same sort of time, I saw this big drum called the dol, the big one.
Yeah.
And I thought, oh my God, thunder.
Yeah.
You know, I thought, wow, thunder.
Yeah.
And then what happened was I had a go on this drum, and everything that I learned in tabla, I transported it onto the dol.
Yeah.
I thought, well, I can play this drum. You see what I mean?
Yeah.
And then I you know, slightly moved away from tabla and focused more on this new drum.
Mm.
And then I started playing that, and then played this for years and years and years, and just, you know, brought everything from double onto the drum.
Mm-hmm.
I brought like a drum kit onto the drum.
Mm-hmm.
You know, where you got your kick and your snare,
yeah,
things like that.
Yeah.
So I basically improvised.
Wow.
Brought, you know, other sort of sounds, different sounds onto the drum.
It's interesting.
Yeah, and now I mm-hmm. I actually teach. I have my own school, Ministry of Dol. Just over 120 students.
That's a lot.
Yeah.
You have time to travel and tour and. I mean, it must be.
It's hard, but what I've done is, I mean, I've got a panel of like tutors, team leaders.
Yeah.
These guys take over when I'm not there.
Yeah.
I've basically taught these guys
how to contain things.
Exactly. Yeah. How to basically, I've given them what's the word? Basically, the full training on what they need to know about the instrument, about playing, about technique, and also about teaching as well.
Yeah, that's important.
Exactly. I mean,
just playing the instrument without teaching is.
You need to be able to teach. If you want to teach, you need to be able to teach.
Because you need to be able to give that
exactly.
information,
exactly.
Pass the information.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. I mean, I've been teaching. I've had the ministry of Dawn since 1993, so that's a long time. That's a hell of a lot of experience in teaching as well. Yeah. You know, different levels. My youngest student is 6. My oldest student is 64.
Was jazz much of an influence to you at any time?
I listened to a lot of jazz. I can't really name a lot of artists.
Mm.
I listened to jazz, but I didn't really get into jazz. I mean, with music, I listen to all sorts of music.
Yeah.
I don't really stick to one type of
feel. It seems to be the band, anyway. How most members of your band seem to be like that.
Right, yeah, yeah.
I mean, I'm not like that myself either, so you don't have to worry.
Right. I mean, I think being a musician, you need to experience different types of music, you know.
Yeah.
Jazz is great. I love jazz because I'm mostly into, I'd say, chill out sort of music.
Yeah.
Because what we do with you know, with Asian dub,
it's quite heavy already.
Yeah,
isn't
it's
it?
Very much in your face.
Yeah, yeah.
And I mean, it'd be great if you could hear that sort of music every time.
Yeah.
But I like to, you know, when I'm not doing Asian dub,
mm-hmm.
I like to just chill out in my own little
cocoon
world. Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, chill out music. You know, bring the heart rate down.